Good evening. My name is Alexander Hagen. I'm the CEO of a medium-sized tech company in Silicon Valley. Previously, I was a financial analyst and a financial journalist. Prior to that, I was a research engineer in telecommunications. I'd like to speak to you tonight about the growing police state of the United States and the context it operates within, which is a growing minimum wage economy, and what we can do about it. Now, I have produced very few videos, in fact, none in the last 5 months, because I've made a commitment to only talk about the solution fundamentally. I've gone over the problem in great detail. For example, that our federal government contractors are largely military, Lockheed, Northrop, Boeing, Raytheon, Science Applications International, General Dynamics, Kellogg Brute and Brown and Root. These are all companies involved in wrong livelihood. They are involved in bombing. I don't want to antagonize people that are in the military or in the police systems. These people need roles in our society. So we have to move from swords to plowshares. Now, there's two basic principles we can use to be able to change the direction of our civilization from one of growing misery in the United States to one of great happiness and prosperity. The first is to change our system of government. The system of government doesn't work anymore, doesn't serve the people anymore. The best way for us to model a new system of government is based on internet voting. And we can do this in such a fashion that as internet voting becomes more and more popular in an alternative governmental structure, once we have more votes than the current system, it'll gain a legitimacy. So we have to start building an internet-based democracy that allows us to make new rules, because the Constitution from the 1780s is simply no longer functioning. We can allot it all we want, as Ron Paul has done and as libertarians have done, but it doesn't work anymore. Now, the second thing we need to do is we have to realize that since we can't vote anymore, it doesn't mean anything. Of course, you should continue to vote hopelessly with this current system. We have to vote with our money. And to that, I have a paragraph that I wrote already. Self-organizing. So in the meantime, for we the people to regain control over our society's direction, we must self-organize to impact local government and local resource ownership and production. That is through starting businesses and organizations to compete with the current monopoly system. So I run a small internet company, and the function of my internet company may be to provide faster internet or to provide unique differentiators with the large internet companies, the large telecom companies. But fundamentally, what we do is we employ local people. We take the money from our customers to employ local people, and we pay them living wages. And we give them a dignity and a voice in the governance and management. So we need to take each of our regions and take it back. There is a struggle between the 50% of the world that's owned by the 1% and the 50% of the world that's still owned by the other 99%. And we have to vote by buying from each other locally. And the economy is organized in such a way right now where the vast majority of jobs really produce nothing. Now, on the face of it, so what am I talking about? Well, by attempting to excite people to feel like that they have unfulfilled needs, and create even new unfulfilled needs they didn't even know they have. This doesn't liberate us from work. It does not free us to pursue our higher interests. So I would say that we need to organize ourselves so that we make things again in our communities, that we and that each of us should get involved in ownership through a cooperative or whatsoever, in something like a medical university cooperative that would take care of education and medicine, and it could act as the anchor for the K-12 system. Something like a network of organic farms that we could either buy from, invest in, do sweat equity in, and also to reintroduce manufacturing. And it will be more costly and less efficient, but we can focus on quality, and we are employing each other. So if we study employment in this country, it is quite concerning, and I've been going through it. So, but let's focus on the solution before we look at the problem. So there's two parts of the solution. One is to take back economically in the local area, and the other is to build a new system of governance based on the an internet model. Of course, some people would be worried about hacking and so forth, but all of this is solvable. Now, how is it solvable? There are algorithms for being able to create fraud-proof elections, and if we all get involved, we can create them. For example, in Florida, when there was a problem between Gore and Bush, people say, well, who did the voter actually intend to vote for? Well, ask him. It's absurd that once this line is drawn, you can't ask people. So I worked on these concepts of being able to issue digital receipts and so forth, so that if there ever was a question, somebody could determine whether their vote was counted accurately. You would have a receipt, and you would look at the vote to make sure that it matched your receipt. Right now, you can't go online and audit your voting card. So this will end part one, and I'll pick up with part two and part three and part four later. My name is Alexander Hagen. Thank you, good night, and good luck.